Coming up next, it is a welterweight championship fight between Nick Diaz and Nate Diaz. Well, a long winning streak may guarantee you a title fight in other divisions, certainly doesn't at 170 pounds. But now, with all the contenders behind him, there is one man left standing. It is this man, the number one welterweight contender, now getting his shot as the dominant champion. And he believes without a shadow of a doubt that he is the best 170 in the world. And he is out to prove it right here, right now. The reigning, defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion in a division full of killers. He has remained the hunted at 170 pounds. Now, unquestionably staring at his toughest challenger to date, can he go back home as the champion? If he can, another chapter to one of the greatest welterweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen. All right, now let's get you our tale of the tape for this welterweight championship fight. Diaz is 35. Diaz is 37. The rest of the numbers are nearly identical. All right, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Dan Mergliotta.
And now! This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC welterweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 21 wins, 13 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Stockton, California, introducing the challenger, Nate Diaz. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 26 wins, 11 losses, and 2 no contests. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Stockton, California, USA, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Nick Diaz!
All right, this is for the UFC Championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
You ready?
All right, folks, here we go with round one. This is not the Eddie Bravo Invitational. This is the UFC, and two of the more decorated Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belts we have in this or any division.
Yes, in any division. We've never seen guys that can
really incorporate the jiu-jitsu into fighting, as we've seen this two do. But who's gonna make a mistake? Who's gonna leave an arm out there to get grabbed? Who's gonna leave their neck out? Let's see, when you put two great jiu-jitsu players together, who can get their hand raised in the octagon?
And they separate. Well, he continues to stay busy, and he continues to land with volume punches here.
I mean, volume, but he's not wasting anything. He's so accurate out there.
Oh, and he connects there. His hands look good to me.
So fast. I mean, this guy has tremendous hand speed.
Oh, he hurt it bad with the jab.
Oh, straight left counter. That'll work. Nice connection there by Nate Diaz. Not a guy you want to let get going here on the feet, DC.
No, this is all downhill with Nate, right? It's the activity that will overwhelm his opponents, and this looks like the start of that.
Oh, beautiful jab there, man. It's like you know what's coming, can't stop it.
I mean, you have to anticipate that jab coming, or he will batter and bruise you with that single strike.
So just over 20 total strikes have already landed for Nate Diaz.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow you? Big punch from the clinch.
And they separate. Diaz's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Lands flush with that right hand. Oh, timing his shots pretty well here early, DC.
He's doing a great job of mixing things up, keeping busy, being very active.
Spinning back fist is there.
What a wrestler. That was an amazing takedown.
Oh, nicely done there as he escapes back to his feet.
Big powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Right hand upstairs. All right, single collar tie now.
Another one. Yep. Oh, and the left hand.
Punch is lost. 45 seconds remain in the round. Well, I'm an identical twin. Two is better than one. You might as well double up on the jab. He did so effectively there.
Doubling up with the jab, and you see his opponent's head popping back every time it lands. Look at those weapons. Look at how he uses his knees to the body.
And he lands a punch there. Pretty good connection by him.
Great connection. He's in a great flow right now.
Man, is he timing his shots well here tonight, DC. It's hard to recall him being this accurate in the past.
I mean, he is so sharp. And not only is he accurate, he's also keeping very busy.
All right, let's take a look back at some of the replays from that last round.
Unbelievable to see these high-level competitors get in each other's face, tuck their chin, bite down on the mouth guard, and just let it all hang out over the course of 5 minutes.
All right, DC, second round is getting underway. Round one, not the round of the year necessarily, but some good in there.
And it's not always gonna be. Yeah, very talented fighters. Sometimes it's very even. That's what we saw in round number one.
He loaded up on that right hand, too.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection. And these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
Oh, big punch man.
All right, so a nice shot there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming.
And now he's hurt.
That's one of those shots that if you take one of them, if in the night, that one landed right on the spot.
Spinning back fist. And he's looking for that left hand, just missed. Both guys really throwing with authority. Trying to establish that jab once again.
Nice punch there.
Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combination. That one appeared to stun him.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Gets caught by that straight punch. That'll get his attention. Oh, lands that That's as good a punch as he's thrown all night.
The punch that lands down the middle, the one that you don't feel, is the ones that land perfect, and that one landed perfect.
Oh, spinning back fist lands. Just misses with the jab.
Big punch lands through the middle.
Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now. He is getting lit up right now, John.
Oh, big left hook there. Oh, huge strike lands there, and somehow his opponent's chin held up.
But you do not want to be on the receiving end of those types of strikes.
All right, good job by him there to raise the guard and protect his head.
He's doing a good job of keeping the guard high, blocking his hit.
And really nice job to finish the takedown there. Close guard. Continues to attack here. We'll see if he can set up the arm bar. Swollen now. And the horn sounds on round two. All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. A stunner there with the head strike midway through. Nearly got him out of there for good.
Almost got him out of there. He hurt him badly. He had his opponent hurt real bad. Now his opponent's walking back to his corner. Everybody looks confused. They don't know what they're supposed to do to try to change the way that this fight is going.
All right, the action continues here and now as our next round gets underway. The previous round had been confused for a round of the year, but pretty good action.
It was a pretty good round. Not every round is going to have you standing up out of your seat. You understand that you are watching the highest level of fighting in the entire world.
Try to establish that jab. Man, how good is that jab from Nate Diaz? Almost as if he's been doing it for 20 years, right?
I mean, he has been doing it. You know, he's got a great boxing coach in Richard Perez, a guy that he believes in, a guy that has allowed him to gain the confidence to stand with the best strikers in the world.
Diaz gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Right hand upstairs. Big shots being landed on both sides here. How good is that right hand?
Yes, you heard him in the last round. Same exact one. Leg kick.
And he connects there with a punch, so pretty good striking display by him thus far.
He throws everything so straight and so accurate.
Lands for him. He is really putting his strikes together tonight.
I mean, he's feeling himself tonight, John.
Wow! Oh, straight right.
Oh, he's hurt. He needs to start looking to...
Just misses there with the left. Swing and a miss with that punch by Diaz. Oh! And just like that, the fight is over.
Oh, my goodness. What a performance.
You knew if he landed that weapon repeatedly, it could be a short night for his opponent. But that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. It landed flush. And the rest, as they say, is history. Big knockout win for him here tonight. All right, let's get you some replays now. Certainly a lot for our replay guys to work with in the truck. This was a clinic tonight in terms of mixed martial arts acumen in every realm of the game.
A full-on display of all of his skills. He did everything in this championship-winning performance. He used his wrestling. He used his elbows. He used his pace and pressure to really wear down his opponent so that he can get his hand raised.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3:52 of round number 3. Going the winner by knockout and new undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Nate Diaz.
All right, so there is a new world order at 170 pounds. Congrats to the new